Hey guys, welcome in this new Marketo tip. Today we will talk about the Marketo Salesforce integration and how easy it is to integrate Marketo and Salesforce. And we will see in detail how this integration works. I'm Sylvain Avril, founder of Merlin and Leonard, and certainly Leonard's team, and this is a new Marketo tip. So the Marketo Salesforce integration is a native integration. It means that we don't have to do any development in order for that to work. It usually takes between half a day and a day to complete the integration and to have the first batch flown from Salesforce to Marketo. Here on this page, we can see all the data that will be exchanged between the systems. The most important one being the persons here in Marketo that will be connected to the leads and contact in Salesforce. So the integration is bi-directional, meaning that person in Marketo can create leads and update contacts. And on the other side, leads and contact from Salesforce can create and update persons in Marketo. So create, update, and delete are supported and also merge here. If you merge two leads or two contacts in Salesforce, it will be pushed to Marketo and the matching person will be also merged in Marketo. We have unidirectional flows for account, opportunities, the users, and the custom object. So all the accounts from Salesforce, visible by the Marketo user will be pushed to Marketo. All the opportunities and their attached contacts will be also pushed to Marketo. Here for the campaigns and campaigns member, we have a bi-directional flow, meaning that we can mirror in Salesforce all the Marketo programs we have created, meaning it's more the programs than the campaigns met. So just to be precise, we will have in Marketo all the users, meaning that the marketing can send emails on behalf of the sales guy. We will also have all the custom objects that are visible by the Marketo user in Salesforce pushed to Marketo. That's very interesting to do some personalized customer marketing. And some activities, so the task elements will be pushed from Salesforce to Marketo, and some of the activities will be pushed from Marketo to Salesforce, only the one the marketing want to push. Interesting to note also, as soon as you create any custom field on any of those objects, if this field is visible by the Marketo user in Salesforce, it will be pushed after 5 minutes to Marketo. That's great because you don't need the IT team to update your integration. You can manage your own fields in Marketo and Salesforce and map them very easily. So the merge is seen from Marketo and pushed to Marketo. We talked about that. The conversion, the lead conversion to contact will also be seen to Marketo, and we can trigger an action as soon as, for instance, a lead is converted to a contact. We see in Marketo all the sales people and also the SNN queues. So Marketo can directly push a hot lead to the correct sales or the correct queue. And we can manage multiple queues in Marketo. We can also create tasks from Marketo for some users in Salesforce. For instance, if you push a lead and you want to create a task so that the user is notified in Salesforce, you can do that. And the record types are also managed in Marketo. So a very thorough integration, easy to roll out, and with a number of objects to be complete. How does that work exactly? So let's switch to Salesforce now. So how does that work in detail? We have three steps to do. First is to create a Marketo user dedicated for Marketo. So we need a dedicated license to do that. and we will create a specific profile for this user. So all the visibility will be managed into Salesforce. Meaning that in the profile and also in the role here, I didn't put any role. So meaning that this marketer user sees everything. But we can restrict or fine-tune the visibility this marketer user will have on any data or any object in Salesforce based on the profile. So any data and data model that this user sees will be pushed to Marketo. So that's how we fine-tune the parameter of data we want to push to Marketo. It's very easy to do. And then on the contrary, the marketing team manage in Marketo what are the leads that will be pushed to Salesforce. Usually it's based either on the score or on the fact that, for instance, a contact form has been filled out. So that's another system. But from Salesforce to Marketo, everything is managed here between the user, the profile, and the role. The second step is to create some fields on the lead and the contact. And I don't know if it will, I will see, no. In the, we recognize the field because, yeah, they have MKTO 71 in the technical field name. So we have like 15 fields to create on the lead and the contact, and then to map those fields from lead to contact. So that's the integration will work. So that's not a big deal. Then we have to make the objects and the fields visible to the user market. This is the longest part because you may not want to make everything visible from Marketo. You want to restrict as much as possible so that your integration is smooth and fast. If you push all the objects and all the fields to Marketo, every round of integration may take more than 5 minutes. And for instance, it may take 20 minutes. So the sync will be done every 20 minutes, basically. So you want to keep that as lean as possible. So the third step we need to do is then into Marketo on the Salesforce admin field. Here we just input the credential we got from Salesforce, the token. We fine-tune some options here, whether we want to enable the campaign sync, the default values and things like that, and you push the button that will get all the Salesforce data model in Marketo. Then we have the mapping step. So on this screen, it's almost like that when we do the first mapping, but you can map all the fields from Salesforce with those from Marketo you want. All the standard field will already be mapped. And for instance, here, if I take city, I can map this city from Marketo to the city on the lead and on the contact so that when the lead is converted to a contact, the flow will continue. Once the mapping is done, we just push the button and the sync will start and be triggered every 5 minutes, as long as your sync takes less than 5 minutes, and you may then monitor all the flows here in this tab. You will see all the detailed flow here, whether it worked or not. You can filter here and all the sync errors here. So I don't have any errors for the moment. That's great, but it's pretty thorough, pretty great to manage. Usually we don't have much problem with the Salesforce integration. The problem you can have, for instance, if you have put in Salesforce a lot of flows, workflows, procedure, triggers, as soon as an object that is synced is inserted or updated in Salesforce, usually we can have a Stack Overflow in Salesforce because we tend to push batches of contacts, campaign members, or programs or tasks in Salesforce, and that can trigger the limits. In the next Marketo tip, I will talk about all the great advantages you have once you have synced Marketo and Salesforce, whether in sync, whether useful for the segmentation, the smart list, the triggers you have, and all the information that the sales can get from the marketing and how they can respond to the marketing. We'll see that in the next session. I hope that was useful. Don't hesitate to ask any question and talk to you soon. Bye-bye.